I want to welcome you to the Modern Institute of Reflexology. Today we're going to be demonstrating Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager. The acronym for that is DRUMMER, and that's what we call it, the DRUMMER. So get ready, there's going to be a lot of action. We have a wonderful candidate, Stephanie, here today that's volunteered to come in. She's never experienced anything like this in her life, so it's going to be a wonderful time for all of us as she experiences the dynamic of percussion reflexology, and we get to enjoy her experience together. So let's get started. So we just want you to just, you know, relax. We'll be working on you.
Okay.
And just don't be afraid to, if it hurts, to yell or scream, you know.
Okay.
I mean, I've had people curse when I was working on them.
All right.
So I want you to feel totally free to relax and be yourself. Don't worry about the cameras staring at you.
Okay.
I mean, it's just like it's you and me.
Okay.
And Jesus.
And Jesus. Got it.
You got it? Okay. So you're safe because everything we do is under his auspices.
Okay.
The DRUMMER, an acronym for Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager, is made in the USA. Isn't that wonderful? A product made in our country that you can buy here, use here, and all the proceeds of it stay here. That helps the economy, right? So today we're getting ready to get started. Over here you can see some of the tips that we're going to be using. I'm going to select them from time to time, change them. We're going to start with the 2-inch wooden tip. So we're going to caution you, if you should ever become the owner of one of these machines, and that is the objective of this demonstration, to encourage you as a professional to get a professional tool that will last you the rest of your life. Now, when you go to put one of these tips on, you want to over-tighten it, just snug it up so it won't come unscrewed. Now, we need our sock. We're going to put a sock on one foot, and we're going to leave the other foot bare. And the reason for the sock is to cushion the foot and protect it from the violence of the percussion action. Now we're ready to go with this. And the reason we're going to use this one is we're going to create a piezoelectrical effect. In other words, as this machine concusses or percusses the foot with this percussion action, we're going to be releasing from the crystalline structure in the skin, the muscles, and the bones a charge of electricity that's inherently contained within each crystalline structure. So we're going to get started here with Stephanie. And okay, we're going to be concussing this area of the foot here. This involves the kidney one meridian. So we're going to primarily be working on the sock foot. It feels what?
Feels pretty good.
Does feel good?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Tickles a little bit.
A little what?
Tickles a little bit.
Tickles a little bit. Oh. You'll notice I'm holding the handle of the tool upwards. That's so I can come in directly. You'll notice my arm is in alignment with the tool so I can get the most pressure without injuring my wrist. You'll notice that my left hand is on top of the foot. It acts as the anvil. This is the hammer. Do you have an injury to your bones in your foot from a past accident?
From volleyball, yeah.
Volleyball? Well, the piezoelectricity will help to open that up. So if there's any further healing that needs to occur, that'll facilitate it. I'm coming up. I'm going to get these metatarsal phalangeal joints. Notice how I pull them over and come up and percuss them. The piezoelectricity courses through the body from the feet as it's released from the crystalline structure all the way to the top of your head. Now, after I've done this for a couple of minutes, I'm going to stop, and I'll tell you when to close your eyes, and I want you to observe your body inwardly, and just so you can, by closing your eyes, see what's going on inside.
Okay.
But you don't need to close them yet, but when I tell you to close them, that means I'm about ready to stop this particular activity. But you can leave them open and enjoy the view.
All
right. Main thing, I want you to have fun while you're here.
I am.
You're having fun?
Yes.
You're having fun? What's the key word when you're having fun? Hallelujah.
There you go.
Well, that's the key word when you're not having fun, too.
Okay.
So either way, I want to hear a good word expressed. Some people curse. Well, I've heard some pretty good curse words in my day. Okay, now close your eyes and just observe what's going on in your body. What do you notice?
I notice relaxation and kind of a pulsing throughout the whole thing. That's about it.
Well, that's it. So you do feel a sort of a settling, like a sinking into the chair.
Yes.
And it's like almost becoming one with the chair.
Yes.
Total relaxation.
Yes.
Total and complete.
I would agree. Yes.
Okay. Well, as we continue this treatment, I want you to observe over here what I have in my hand. I neglected to initiate this first part of the treatment, but better late than never. As you get older, sometimes you forget. And with all the excitement of Stephanie being here today, I forgot to ground her to the earth. This is a ground that I'm going to put under her calf. And what that does is we stir up all this static electricity. It's got to go somewhere. So by grounding it to a stake in the earth, which we've done here, then that allows her to get a better treatment outcome. So forgive me, Stephanie, for not installing
that
like I should have. Okay, now we're going to progress on to another tip. Tip different than this one. This is a 2-inch wooden tip. The wood is sort of a neutral substance, whereas stainless steel tends to sedate. Gold color tends to stimulate or activate within the body. So what I'm going to do now is demonstrate the 3/8 inch on the end, that's 3/8 inch stainless steel probe. Now this is going to be a little different, Stephanie. Are you ready for a change of pace?
Yes.
Let's get the action of this. So we have the percussion action. Now this percussion action that you see occurs as this shaft comes from the motor and turns and causes a flywheel with a cam on it to drive this shaft in and out. Percussion is the action we're involved with here. We're going to turn that up to 4,400 impacts per minute.
All right.
And specifically, the kidney one is located right between these two metatarsal phalangeal joints. As you can see on the chart, we have a cutaway chart of the Chinese acupuncture system, and since we're related to acupuncture and the mechanism of action, we're going to go in on this point. Anvil in place, my hand. And now we're going to begin to probe. Now, tell me when you feel this hit that kidney one meridian point. It'll be like a needle in there. It'll be a real small little point. Do you feel it?
Yeah.
Yeah, what does it feel? What do you mean? Yeah.
Like little needles.
Little needles, okay.
Yeah, I mean not needles.
Eye needles. Oh, prickles.
Yeah.
Okay. That's pretty good. Not most people can keep a straight face through that. Tell me what you feel there. Can you feel? Am I getting it?
Yeah.
Right there?
Yeah.
Oh. Kind of I saw your wrinkle. Your brow sort of wrinkled. Yeah. Okay. Now, by going in and deeply working that kidney one meridian, that's also known as the Chinese sleep point.
Oh.
So people that have trouble with insomnia, this is a good point to work. If you go to Modern Institute of Reflexology's website, on the self-treatment page, we show you how to work this point with two golf balls. If you follow those directions explicitly, you can work your own kidney one meridian point.
Fantastic.
And you don't have to come and see me. Save your money. But the percussion action has a way of getting the job done in a way that's unique to any other type of a stimulus. Okay, that's the primary reason for this. But we can also use it on what's known as the pituitary reflex, right in here. Do you feel any of those?
Uh-huh.
Could be one right in there somewhere. That's Inga Dugan's pituitary point. She's from South Africa. Right in there?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Well, that's the kidney one probe, 3/8 diameter. But let's go to a different one. Here's what I call the 1-inch Chinese mallet. Now, in ancient history, Chinese would use hammers to pound on the bottom of the foot. I said, wow, with this machine and the right tip, I can simulate what they're doing and get even a better result because of the high number of impacts per minute. So here we go with our 1-inch Chinese mallet. This will feel a little differently than the 2-inch one, because it's a little more specific. Now we're working the toes. This relates to your head. Let's see if we can get in there. With my finger, that's the anvil now, and I put it on your toenail, and we're able to work not only reflexes on the bottom part of the toe, but we're getting all those reflexes under the nail itself. Can you feel that working under the nail?
Yeah.
And that's just the soft part of my finger. If I put my fingernail there, it gets even a little more penetrating.
Yeah.
See? But our stimulation of all those points in the toes is very dynamic. So if you have any feedback for me, speak it out.
Feels good, that's all.
Feels good?
Yeah.
Oh, it does not. Some people tell me, oh my God, that's killing me.
Nope.
But you're younger and in better health than a lot of the old fogies I work on. I say old fogies like me. I'm 75, so I think I'm in the old fogie category. Feels good, huh? Well, going to be encouraging for anybody that watches the video. Feels good. This is what you call painless reflexology, yet dynamic, and it gets good results. Because instead of pressing on it one time a second, or 60 times in a minute with my finger, I'm doing it 4,400 in 1 minute. So the dynamic's a lot different. I'm going to work right under here. On Steve Saran's chart, this would be an area to work the heart and the lungs. People have a bad neck, I can come up and lightly work this area here. Now you see the difference between with and without the sock? Mm-hmm. You feel like the sock gives you a little cushion, or does it matter?
It gives you a little cushion, yeah.
Yeah. Now we're coming across the base of the toes here, and that gets all across the shoulder area. Or again, on Steve Saran's chart, you see that relates to the teeth and eyes. I had a lady one time came in with teeth that were turning black, her front ones, and she was very concerned about it. And while I was working on her, she could feel the electrical activity vibrating in her darkest tooth. And a couple hours later, after she left, she called me and said, then it moved from the darkest tooth to the next darkest tooth. She had three of them that were in a varying series of darkness. Mm-hmm. And they started getting lighter.
Wow.
So she came in to show me, and we talked about it. Why don't the dentist know about this type of stuff, you know?
Teeth whitening at its best.
Well, you know, when they start turning black, you suspect that maybe they're dying, you know.
Oh.
So we want to resurrect them and bring them back to life.
There you go.
So we do that by raising the voltage in the area where there's a problem. Mm-hmm. If your voltage gets too low, then you get sick. And you can't, like when you injured your foot, you can't regenerate new cells unless you get the voltage up above normal. Normal is minus 20 to minus 25 millivolts. To make new cells and for it to heal quickly and well, you have to get it up to minus 50 millivolts.
Okay.
If you don't, then you're gonna have problems. Some people that are not too unhealthy to begin with can handle it, but in the old days, when a bone wouldn't heal properly, they would re-break it.
Oh.
That's why they would re-break bones if it wasn't healing right, to get a new current of injury from the brain, to wake the brain up to do its job in the healing process. Right down here is a interesting area. Right there's a what they call the reproductive plexus. Just by working that one point, we can affect every part of the reproductive system. I had a lady one time come to work for me, a young lady, had cysts on both ovaries. And she was in horrible pain. I said, didn't you go to the doctor? She said, yeah, and he told me that I had cysts and that they had to dissolve.
Mm-hmm.
I said, well, did he tell you how to dissolve them? She said, no. So I said, well, let me get work on you here. And I started working on her, and I found this point to be very sensitive.
Uh-huh.
As I sat there hammering it like this.
Yeah, that's sensitive a little bit.
Oh, it is. Oh, well, yeah. Maybe we're going to liven up your right ovary, I'll tell you. All of a sudden, she doubled over in pain. That ovary began to spasm, and when she'd had all she could take, I went to the other foot, and it was the same thing on this foot, because both ovaries were the same.
Yeah, that was sensitive too.
Yeah, well, good. We're going to do you some good today. See, we can detect things in the latent stage before you even realize you might have a problem.
Right.
So, anyway, she got so sick after I worked on her, I sent her home, and 2 days later, she came back.
Wow.
And she was well. The cysts had broken up and taken her a couple days for all the pus and stuff to reabsorb into the body. And she came back and felt wonderful. No more pain.
That's awesome.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then working on this point, I've had women come. The doctor said, well, you got a problem. That's why you can't get pregnant.
Oh.
And so I've worked on numerous ladies that after working on them, one lady came in for 5 treatments, and 10 years later she came in. I said, aren't you the lady I worked on for not being able to get pregnant about 10 years ago? Mm-hmm. She brought someone else in. She didn't even tell me who she was, but I recognized her.
Wow.
Yes, aren't you the lady from Peru? Yes, she said. Well, how did your treatment come out?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, she said, I had a beautiful little girl. She said, I timed it out, and my pregnancy occurred during the time of my second treatment.
Wow. That's awesome.
And she was just so happy, you know.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's pretty rewarding to be able to work with people and see things like that happen.
Oh, absolutely.
I mean, for me, and because I see them being blessed in their life in ways that medical people couldn't get them going. And they're great as far as they can go, but sometimes we find we're all limited in whatever therapies we might give. So what we need to pray for and hope for is advancement into what's known as integrative medicine, where everything is brought to apply on any particular problem. Okay, now we're going to switch to another tip. How did you like that one?
That was good.
That was good. Ooh, my favorite. This is what I call the Texas toe nut.
Awesome. All right.
Yeah, I've designed it where it'll actually grip the toe, the ends of the toes. See?
Hmm.
But like with any of the tips, I can take any one tip and work the whole foot, because once you become used to handling the instrument, then you can use anything that will screw in. So let's get this one screwed in and see how you like that.
All right.
Now remember, as we're stirring you up and getting all kinds of negative energies going, we have the ground on, so all that can flow back into the earth.
Cool.
A lot of people will work on someone, and it'll all go into them. And they get tired. Mm-hmm. They can only work on two or three people a day.
Wow.
And they're totally exhausted. Poor things.
Poor things.
I never had that problem, because I believe in staying full of the Holy Ghost and fire. So I'm able to handle it. But not everybody's able to do that. So the ground that we talked about earlier, see, the grounding device, which is connected to a rod in the earth, we'll take care of all that negative stuff that has to go somewhere.
Get out of there, negative.
Yeah. So now we're going to fire up. Now, why is this called the Texas toe nut? I call it the plain old toe nut because it works the toe.
Okay.
And it's sort of nutty looking.
It is nutty.
But one of my students came from Houston. He said, Zach, I want to tell you, that's the best tip you have of all the tips you've designed. And I said, well, my brother, I'm going to name this in honor of you. You're from Texas. I'm going to call it the Texas toe nut.
Oh.
Now, I didn't tell him that I was born in Texas, but really the only motivation for that was to honor him.
Good.
But he was, okay, here we go. 4,400 impacts a minute. This is real dynamic here. I come right down with this, I can come right down on the tops of the toes. The reason I like to do the ends of the toes is because in the zone therapy, as advocated by our founding father, William Fitzgerald, that's where everything ends, right on the end. So when I find a tender place on the end, that can relate to any problem in that zone. So if all I did was work the toes, I could give a complete treatment and get good results just by working the toes. I can also use this one to do the thumb walk. With reflexologists, they take this thumb walk and they walk all over the foot. And at 75, I've worn out the cartilage in both of my, all three of my thumb joints. So now I've got to use this. So now here's the thumb walk, Zachary style. I'm able to walk the whole foot. That's faster than you could do it by your thumb. More impacts. More thorough coverage, and no strain to my joints. That's the idea of instruments and reflex application, is save your joints. A person has a machine like this, and they massage therapist or reflexologist or whatever, physical therapist, they can extend their career. You can do this till the day you die.
Maybe.
Yeah. and being made in the USA and being able to get parts for it, it'll last you a lifetime.
There you go.
This machine will go and go and go, and when it breaks down, get a part and keep it going. Still get that K1 there a little bit too.
Yeah.
Feel that?
That's full tender, yep.
It's what?
It's full tender.
Let's try down here on that solar plexus, reproductive plexus. Can you feel that? Let's just go in there and get that. Let's get that real good. I think here we go. Ready?
Uh-huh.
It's all right. You can cry.
cry.
Somebody get that woman a hanky. Get her a hanky. Okay, now let's come over here and see if we can get in here. Is it equal on both sides?
Yes.
Yeah? Well, we got you going. That's exciting. Well, let's change to another tip now. I have one that's very interesting. That I designed all these tips for reflex applications, but they can be used anywhere on the body, massage therapist or reflexologist or acupuncturist. Acupuncturists need something to give a little variety. Some people are afraid of needles. So a lot of them have reflexologists coming in to work with them alongside.
No needles for me.
To enhance, yeah. Some people just have an aversion to a needle. Okay. Now this is a very interesting tip. It's stainless steel. It's similar to the Texas toe nut, but bigger. I designed this specifically to work around the heel. But again, I can work the whole foot with it. But let's see how we do going around the heel here. I made it to cup the heel. As you can see on Steve Saran's chart, there are a lot of things around the edge of that heel that have to do with the lower part of the body. Is that too uncomfortable for you? Well, we just finished working on Stephanie. She's in the chair relaxing now, observing what's going on in her body. And we've created a lot of current of injuries at the point where there was pain, like in the reproductive plexus. And we sent a signal to the brain through the perineural sheath of the peripheral nerves and up through the spine into the brain. And that current of injury, as discovered by Dr. Robert O. Becker, signals the brain there's a problem down in that part of the body. The ovaries, if there is a problem, may not be severe, but it showed up. So that's going to cause the brain to send the direct current of regeneration down into the area of the problem. Like I was describing to Stephanie, I had a lady with cysts on both ovaries, pain, the day she came to work for me. Same day I worked on her, horrific pain on that reflex, current of injury to the brain, and the end result was the cyst broke up. She came to work 2 days later. Well, she wasn't sick anymore and no pain. 2 days with the activity of the stimulus of the treatment, was able to clear out all that pus and stuff within that 2 days. She came back to work feeling wonderful with a smile on her face. Okay, we're going to be on Julia's treatment. We're not going to forget to put the grounding plate in. And ground her to the earth. That's
Thank
grounded
you.
To a rod in the earth. So as we stir things up, anything negative that we stir up, like static electricity that needs to go somewhere, it's not going to come into me, or it's not going to keep churning you up. It's going to go into the earth. So we don't have to worry about it.
Great.
Okay. Okay, today we're going to install a tip we haven't used yet. This is the round tip, Chinese mallet. I call them Chinese mallets because that's where I saw in history we have the strongest support for what we do. So this is the rounded Chinese mallet. And Julia's here. This is going to be your first introduction to percussion reflexology.
Great.
So what this does, this machine creates a percussion effect. It's like a guy hitting a punching bag, see? Or a woman hitting a punching bag. See, it's going back and forth, in and out, see? And since we're short on time, I'm going to turn it up to 4,100 impacts in 1 minute. Julia, are you ready?
Okay.
Okay. Here we go. Now we're going to start on the kidney one meridian. Wait a minute. I want them to be able to see where I'm working, so I'm going to take one sock off.
Okay.
Okay, here we go. Kidney one meridian. Anvil. Hammer. Kidney one meridian point, known as the Chinese sleep point. I had a man bring his wife in one time. They were both Chinese, and she couldn't sleep at night. Hadn't slept in months all night long, and she was a mess. So I explained to her, I'm going to work on you, and the primary point I'm going to work is the kidney one meridian. And this is what she said. Ah, Chinese sleep point. Chinese sleep point. Very good, very good. So I worked her over for an hour and a half. When I got done, she would dance around the clinic, just shouting and praising the heavens. And she said, you give me good deal for 10 treatments. You give me good deal, and I pay you now for 10 treatments. And I told her, I said, well, ma'am, you know how to do the reflexology. You got a light. Your husband can work on you. You live a long way away, clear up in Loveland. I said, so you just call me up if you need me. And she left that night loaded with information on how to work on herself, and I never saw her again. I like to enable people to take care of themselves. I don't want you coming back here and blowing all your money for something you can do yourself. So you go to our website, Modern Institute of Reflexology, Google it, go to the self-treatment page, and you can see how to work kidney one meridian with two golf balls effectively.
Golf balls?
Yeah, two golf balls. And you can get really good results if you follow our explicit instructions. But one of the important things to do when you do the golf ball treatment is to follow it, and that has to do with is you increase the pain, and then when you can't take any more, you hold it, then you pray. It's important that you pray. It is. I had one lady say, well, what do I pray? I said, ma'am, if you get enough pain going, something's going to come out of your mouth. It might only be, oh, God, help me.
I appreciate that.
So, if you go, and we have photos there showing you how to do it. If you get that down and experience it, try it out. If you ever get in a bind health-wise, you can do that. I had a lady with fibromyalgia, student, call me up. Zachary, I get home from work, I'm so tired with this fibromyalgia, I can't work on people, I can't study, I can't do anything. I gave her the golf ball recommendation, and that was on Friday night. Sunday night, she called me, Zachary, what do I do? My feet are all swollen. Should I go to the emergency room? I said, well, what do you mean? Well, I did what you said. I got on the balls, and oh, man, I got the pain going, and I prayed. And then I went to bed. That was Friday night. I'm just now waking up. It's Sunday night, Zachary. I think the healing must have begun, but my feet, they're all swollen.
Yeah.
What do I do? And it turns out a month and a half later, she went to the doctor. He pronounced her cured of fibromyalgia.
Oh, wow.
And she did it all herself. I didn't have anything to do with it except to instruct her on the simple technique.
Wow.
But meanwhile, we can do you a good job with the drummer.
Mm-hmm.
Some people come, they like to be worked on by others. Well, we can do that effectively with the drummer, Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager. We can have a whole lot of fun. Okay, now I'm going to be stopping here in a minute.
Okay.
And so I want you to close your eyes and just observe what's going on in your body when I quit. What do you sense or see or feel?
I would say it's an overall total relaxation.
And overall, total. You'll feel yourself becoming one with the chair, sinking down deep into the chair. Yes, it's wonderful. Total and complete relaxation. And that in only 2 or 3 minutes. Now, they told me to move along, so I got to do something dynamic where you'll say, man, I'm glad I went there, even though it wasn't a long treatment.
Oh, I'm glad. I'm already glad I came.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, Julia. You're a winner.
Thank you.
Blessings on you, Julia.
Thank you.
3/4 inch Chinese mallet, very dynamic, and Jill will know that she's had something more forceful than anybody's had up to this time. A 3/4 inch Chinese mallet, administered at the hand of myself, Zachary Brinkerhoff, using the Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager. Are you ready, Jill?
I'm ready.
Okay, now this goes in and out with a percussive action.
Okay.
See? Mm-hmm. I'm going to take it up, since we're short on time,
mm-hmm.
4,200 impacts a minute.
Okay.
I'm going to come in on kidney one meridian. Okay, here we go, Jill. Now, kidney one meridian is, if that's the only point I work, I could give you a whole treatment working that one point. But I'll include this point, too, down here. They're both pretty important. Now, I work from foot to foot because I don't want to leave you out of balance. One time I had somebody say, oh my gosh, I'd only worked on one foot. And they said, oh my gosh, I forgot I got an appointment. They jumped up, ran out the door, paid me, of course, before they left. And they were out of balance. I'd only worked one side. And so they sort of staggered out the door and got in their car and drove off. Now, they said they had an appointment, but who knows, they just may have wanted to get out of there, Jill. Kidney one meridian. 3/4 inch Chinese mallet. This is the, again, the reproductive plexus down here. And on one of the ladies, it was a little sore. But we worked it over for her real good. But you seem to be... How's that feel?
Good,
yeah, feels good. Okay, so you obviously don't have any problems.
I know.
any latent problems there. Like I say, if this is the only point you work right here, we can give a whole treatment. Now, I'm going to come up and work across this area here. When people have a lot of tension in their shoulders, this is an area I work. Just to relax them all across that area. And I don't even have to touch them up there. So why did you show up today, Jill?
Because I need some relaxation.
Need what?
I need some relaxation.
Oh, okay.
Can you tell the top part probably is a lot of stress?
Oh, yeah. Well, then I better... Let me come up and get this one. Well, they're cutting me down on time. I could spend 2 hours on you. Well, I asked her what she came for. Why'd you come all the way over here? She said, to get relaxation. So everybody came for an important reason. We can't cut anybody short. So I'm working the key points to bring relaxation.
And what are the key points of relaxation?
Kidney one meridian. Kidney one meridian is known as the Chinese sleep point.
Okay.
Just by working this one point. Now, as I told the other lady that was here, you go to our website, Modern Institute, go to the self-treatment page.
Mm-hmm.
You can do the golf ball treatment every day, if you do it exactly like we tell you, you can keep that stress to a minimum. You can keep, every day you can treat yourself. Okay. Start the day off with the golf balls, go into the situation relaxed, and then come back at the end of the evening or the day, do it again, and you'll sleep good.
Right.
It'll put you to sleep and resurrect you both. In the morning, resurrect you. At night, put you to sleep, I guarantee it. But by coming here, I can embellish upon your mind a technique you can avail to yourself at no cost. I'll give you two golf balls if you don't have any. Do you have any?
Some.
Oh, you do? Okay, then I don't
I'm
have
I'm not
to.
Very good at golf, so it'll be a better use for it.
Yeah. Well, I never was any good either, Jill. I don't even remember. I didn't keep track of my score after a certain point. It was so bad. It was like 106, you know. That's not very good, is it?
No, probably better than I would be, though.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, we're coming up here and we're working with a 3/4 inch Chinese mallet. The points on the foot, there's three of them, because we consider all the charts, the pituitary, hypothalamus, reflex. And there are other things among those things on the toe. Okay, close your eyes and just relax. Just allow yourself to totally and completely relax. Just observe your body. It'll be almost like sinking down deep into the chair. Total and complete relaxation for Jill. Did you feel the relaxation?
Yes.
Good. Well, just rest assured that with the golf balls, you can go even deeper because you can go longer.
Okay. All right.
So do you have hope?
Yes.
Good. Well, we all have to have hope.
Excited to try it.
Yeah, okay. Well, give me my sock back, and we'll let you up.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Jill, for coming.
Thank you for having me. It was good.
Yeah, wonderful.
I didn't know I'd be getting this on my day off. So.
Oh, your day off. Well, yeah. Well, if these guys didn't have another appointment they have to go to, we could spend a little more time with each person, but at least I know how to give you the dynamic.
Right.
So in a short period of time, you can get the rush of of relaxation.
Thank you very much.
Yes, ma'am.
Blessing. My hands are cold.
Blessing. What's cold?
My hands are cold.
Oh yeah. Well, that's a change in your body. Changes going on in your body just from what we did.
Okay.
And so sometimes people break out in a sweat.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes they'll get cold. But everybody responds differently. But this is a dynamic machine.
Okay.
See, it's not like going in with your finger and pressing like this, see.
Right.
Now, Andrea has a sister.
I worked on that other lady. Raise your legs way up. Now put them down. Ah, oh, beautiful. Wow, spread your toes. That is good. I don't see a toe spread. Look at that little toe.
Because I have big toes.
Well, and the big toe, see, it's injured because it should come out like that. But the little toe and all the others look pretty good. But this one here is suffering.
Yeah, I need a lot of work done.
Probably,
they hurt.
Probably I don't know if it's wearing shoes or it's genetic, but.
It's because I have flat feet, so all my pressure goes to there. So I had expensive soles made.
Yeah.
I found out too late.
Yeah. Flat feet, huh? Yeah, that's hanging down there pretty low. I mean, I've seen them worse.
Oh, yeah.
I mean, I'd say this is sort of a mid-range arch.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, believe me, some people walk and this bone's banging on the ground.
Yeah.
And that is no fun. Okay, we... So how far did you come, Deanna, to get here?
It took about 25, 30 minutes.
Wow, that's a long way to come.
Luckily there wasn't no traffic.
Wow. It was 45 minutes. What part of the area?
Like, do you know what Glendale is?
Oh, Glendale. Well, yeah, you had to go straight across Denver to come out 6th Avenue.
Mm-hmm.
Glendale. Well, depending on traffic, you know, you might make it in 25 or 30.
Yeah, it wasn't bad at all.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming. And,
of course.
And the more people we have, the more we have to choose from. We're putting together a DVD of the technique of this machine.
Oh, okay.
So I can take any one of these tips and give a complete treatment. So I've chosen this tip for you, which is not even an official tip, but I want to use something different. But I like this one, so I'm going to have fun with it.
Okay.
And I hope you can benefit. Now, what is it that you would like to get out of this treatment today?
Just to relax. I don't have pain anywhere.
Okay.
Right now, so.
Okay, well then, I'll focus. Anything I do is going to relax you. But I'll finish with kidney one meridian. It's right here, and that's known as the Chinese sleep point. So. Okay.
Perfect.
Are we ready to get started?
Ready.
So you want me to fire up?
Fire it up.
Okay, we're firing up, and what we have is a percussion action with a quarter inch stroke. If I take it all the way up, it's like a guy punching a punching bag with 4,400 impacts in 1 minute.
Wow.
So this is dynamic reflexology, akin to acupuncture. Only we don't use needles, we use percussion. You ready? This is deep percussion stimulation that you can't get any other way than with Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager or an equivalent device. The old thumb technique just isn't going to get the result. Have you had reflexology before?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, since you've had it before, you can sense the difference.
Mm-hmm.
Kidney one, I mean, look at that. Just close your eyes and feel the overwhelming impact of the release of piezoelectricity from your feet clear to the top of your head.
Mm-hmm.
Right? Yeah.
I went to esthetician school, so I learned a little bit about reflexology.
Yeah. Well, if you do it professionally, like I have, I'm 75. I started when I was 26. I've worn the joints out, all three joints in each thumb. That's six joints. No cartilage left. And I was using instruments all those years.
Yeah.
But as the years have gone on, I've less and less used the thumbs anymore.
You don't need to because of this.
No, I don't need to because of this. I just got better instruments, so I didn't have to use my thumb.
Yeah.
Esthetician school. Yeah, there's a lot of manicurists, pedicurists adapt reflexology as part of their practice. I've got people that say have a clinic out of their home.
Yeah.
In Golden, I have a lady, and she does everything cosmetology-wise,
mm-hmm.
but she has a whole clinic.
Yeah.
Where she does reflexology in her home. And then her backyard's like an oasis where people can go out and wait and relax.
Mm-hmm. That's awesome.
So she's done it. I got her story on the website.
Yeah.
If you ever. Now, on my. On the Modern Institute of Reflexology, on the self treatment page, I explicitly show how to use two golf balls.
Mm-hmm.
To work the kidney one meridian specifically, and to get everything you need by working at one point. Keep it simple.
Exactly.
I had one of my colleagues, a retired chiropractor, on my advisory board, came to me one day and he said, Dr. Brinkerhoff, you got to find one point. You got to come up with one point that we can work and get the job done. We got to simplify this reflexology thing. There are just too many points. It's too confusing to people. So I had a project, so I started working on it, and I thought back over all the treatments I'd given, began to experiment, and this is the one I came up with. By working this one point, I can create a bioelectrical cascade to the 12 major meridians of the body, and I can do that in about 10 minutes, and the energy or the voltage flows from one meridian to the other by working both feet. 10 minutes. The bioelectrical cascade, I call it. That's what's going on right now. We're jacking you up with voltage. with voltage. So it's a lot. This makes it a lot of fun because I don't have to work hard, and people get good results. I mean, I could give 15-minute treatments a day if I was down in an area of town where there were a lot of people. Well, if old people, if Medicare paid for old folks, I'd have them lined up right here waiting to get in just to give them a nice jolt, you know. Keep them going. Keep them moving. Keep them flexing. But the medical people won't let it happen because I've had one doctor tell me, Zachary, if Medicare pays for you guys, pays you guys for what you do, then I'll have to go out of business. Because Zachary, there's just so much money in Medicare to go around. I have to close my office. So they're in a panic over the emergence of holistic, alternative, holistic medicine, some refer to as alternative therapies, or whatever. Call it whatever you want. This is simulating walking barefoot on the rocks in the gravel driveway. Go do it in the driveway yourself. But some people like to be pampered and worked on, so they come in and, hey, I'll oblige them up to a point. But I got to run a school. I don't have time to do the same person over 3 times a week for the rest of their life. I send them out to a graduate and let them do it.
Exactly. So why do you have one sock on and one sock off?
Well, I just want them to be able to see more clearly on the foot where I'm working, but I prefer to work the foot through a sock because it sort of gives you, as you can tell by the feel, sort of a little protective barrier from the, at least psychologically, when you first come in, I put socks on both feet, you don't feel so threatened with all the dynamic that's going on. It's just something I sort of learned on my own, and now I advocate to all the students. We are the Modern Institute of Reflexology. We are a state-approved school, and we do train people to be professional reflexologists. So using socks is, I think, part of it. It protects them. It creates a dry barrier for the transmission of any microbes that, from wet body fluids. Dry sock, cotton, very absorbent, and we're not going to get that. Going to come up here and put dynamic on these toes. See, my finger's the anvil, and this is the hammer, and we're just beating the p-wadding out of that little sucker. If all I did was work on the toes, I'd get a good treatment outcome. Because in sujok therapy, the Russians say the whole body is contained in the whole toe, or a single toe or a single finger. I could take your 2 thumbs or your 2 great toes and work nothing but them, or just one of them, and create a dynamic in the whole body. But primarily what we're doing is raising the voltage. Chinese call it energy, but for the Western mind, we figure out, well, that energy they're talking about is the voltage the body operates on. For example, we function at minus 20 to minus 25 millivolts. Down to 15 millivolts, you don't feel too good. 10, you feel sick. 5, you're ill. You get down below 0 millivolts, you develop cancer. You're anaerobic. Mm-hmm. You don't want to get that low on vitality. So basically what we're doing is helping to raise the voltage of the body with our therapies. Of course, you can do that with good live food, sunshine, exercise. All those things help to raise your voltage. There's no one thing that you can count on. You have to blend all these things into your lifestyle. When I work across here, it's to release tension in the muscles across the neck and shoulder. Depending how bad it is, it takes more or less work. thing, whatever you do, you want to have fun. And, hey, I had fun. I'm having more fun today with Brian number two here, helping out, hanging in, trying to not think about the next job and the possibility of being late because so many ladies showed up. Mike gave too good of a sales pitch, huh? You wanted to make sure at least one showed up. Well, I'm glad everybody came. Give you one last thrust here, and then I'm going to stop. And when I stop, I'm going to tell you to close your eyes, and I'm going to quit, and just take a moment to see how the dynamic has affected you insofar as relaxation goes, okay? I want you to observe your body and then just share what it is that you're observing or feeling. Okay? Okay, close your eyes, hone in on her. You just want to allow yourself to totally and completely relax. It's almost like you feel like yourself sinking down deep into the chair. I say it's sort of like becoming one with the chair. It's a weird concept, but total and complete relaxation. So have you been able to sense that relaxation, Cindy?
I feel jello, like I'm jello, like my body's jello.
You feel like you're jello. Well, is that, that's a good feeling for you, isn't it? Jello. You feel like you're jello. Let's just enjoy your jello state. Nothing like feeling like jello. Well, I want you to take that jello state with you now and maintain. Don't allow anything to get to you in your mind and your spirit. Don't let your will be played with. Your emotions will stay intact now. Maintain. Cindy. Cindy is your name?
Deanna.
Oh, Deanna. I got you mixed up. Sorry, Deanna.
It's okay. Might call me Danielle, so it works.
Danielle?
I can be anybody, I guess.
Oh, gosh. Jello.
Amazing.
Amazing. Amazing. And I didn't work that long, did I?
No, but you did it.
I did it. Well, this is what did it. This percussion. The percussion action of Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager. 4,500 impacts a minute is what did it. On the kidney one
That's
meridian,
awesome.
Chinese sleep point is what kidney one is known. Kidney one.
I'm ready to go to sleep.
Yeah. Well, sorry about that. If I gave you a full treatment, I would use light energy to resurrect you at a certain point.
Yeah.
Enjoy your relaxation. You need to do that. So take it with you, and you can make, you know, be sure to make the most of what's happened to you today.
Yes.
And go to our website, Modern Institute of Reflexology, Google it, and go to our self-treatment page and find out how to use a golf ball on each foot simultaneously to do the same thing to yourself. Well, it'll come about in a different way, but you know, you can get the relaxation.
Mm,
I don't know if you feel like jello, but you'll be able to maintain. We got you started, now you maintain it.
Perfect.
Okay? If you need a couple golf balls, I have some I can give you. Do you have
any? Oh, I have some.
Oh, do you?
Okay. Yeah.
Okay, well, thank you very much.
Thank you.
It was wonderful to have you in the chair.
Appreciate it. It was wonderful to be in the chair.
Yeah. Okay, this is your ground. We're connected you to the earth through a grounding rod.
Mm.
So as we stir all this negative electricity up, all the static fields of electricity, they got to go somewhere. They're going to go down into the earth. I don't want them coming back into me. Okay, so today you're going to experience percussion reflexology. You see how that goes in and out? This shaft that twists is going into a flywheel that turns, and there's a cam on it that causes this shaft to go up and down. So we get a cut like a guy hitting a punching bag. See, can you imagine? Or a woman. So we're going to box your feet around today. But everybody seems to think it feels good. Are you ready, Jackie?
Let's do it.
Okay. 4,400 impacts a minute, okay? Is that a little too overwhelming? What does that feel like?
It tickles a little bit. It feels good.
Feels good?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. Tickles, no pain?
No pain.
Wow. These young people, I tell you, not like working on old fogies. Like Mike, boy, he was ready to jump out of the chair. Now you'll feel it through the sock. It'll be a little different feel. I'd like you to tell me if it's more comfortable through the sock or if you prefer it on the barefoot.
I think I like it on the barefoot.
Oh, you like it on the barefoot?
Yeah.
What is it about the barefoot versus the sock?
I feel like the sock tickles more.
Tickles more? Oh, you don't want to tickle. Oh, well, I don't know. If I want you to feel the tickling more than the pain, I might want the sock. But you didn't cry, so you like to drop the sock. Let's try it again. Sure, it doesn't tickle as much, huh?
Mm-mm.
Is it a little rougher so it takes away the tickle?
Yeah.
Well, I'll have to remember that. God, I'm 75, been doing this for years, and I never ask anybody which one they preferred.
Jill asked why you have one on and one off.
Who did?
Jill did, the last one.
I said I had one off so when I come on the foot, they can see where on the foot where the sock might obscure exactly where I'm working. But normally I work with sock on each foot.
Oh, okay. Okay.
It's just for the camera.
Oh, I see. I'm just flattering my
own feet.
Okay.
Thank you.
Who asked that question?
Jill. The one you were talking to me.
Yeah.
I said, yeah. I was like, I don't know.
She was the nurse?
Maybe it
was,
yeah.
Yeah. So. Sock, or does it matter on the toes?
It's good on both the toes. I think it kind of makes my head feel a little tingly.
What, without the sock, or?
And I think both of them.
Oh, with the toes. It's making her head feel tingly. Why is it making her head feel tingly when I work the toes? Well, the toes go to your head.
Mm.
That's where they connect with. Making her head feel tingly, well, boy. Jackie, we're going to have you all jacked up when you leave here. Now, if you have any bad outcomes from us overworking your brain, well, you call me and let me know, and maybe I'll have a suggestion of something you can do to... Well, we had a reaction here working the toes. Describe what happened in your head as I was working the toes. You said a what in your head?
Kind of like a tingly feeling on the two smaller toes.
It made a tingly feeling.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that exciting? It is for me. I like it when people get reactions. The only thing I don't want them to do while I'm working on them is have a reaction that causes them to die. I tell people, if you're going to die, don't die on me in the chair. Wait till you get outside. Then I can call an ambulance or a hearse and they can haul you away. One guy asked me one time, in my full disclosure, it said in there that you could die during or shortly following the treatment. One guy was looking at me sort of strange, you know, and I said, I guess you're looking at me and you're wanting to ask me a question like, has anyone you've ever worked on died? He said, yeah, I would like to know, has anyone you ever worked on died? And I said, well, yes. I told him about an incident that I didn't have. And I held him in rapt attention, right up to the point where, at the end of my story, when the guy dropped dead, it wasn't when he stood up out of the chair, but with the way I worded it, it was 3 weeks later, out in the field. He was a farmer.
Ooh.
And he had had me work on him, and the walls of his heart were like tissue paper. He wanted me to give him an easy treatment, and I did. And he felt great after the treatment. 3 weeks later, he dropped dead out working on the job in the field. So that's as close as I could get to killing someone.
I don't think it was your fault.
Well, I like to take responsibility, even if it's 3 weeks out.
Ooh.
I don't mind. I mean, medical people tell me if your therapy doesn't have any side effects, it's not a therapy. Well, I like to think that we have such powerful side effects. It could kill you. That's how powerful ours are.
Yeah.
The medical people kill you all the time. I just came within 3 weeks of one person that I'm aware of.
Mm-hmm.
So I guess that's okay. Makes people feel good when they hear how far out it was.
It's not happening in the chair.
Yeah, I haven't had anyone die in the chair. I've had them come close. Believe me, I've had some close calls, but one of the cases I had was a lady that was a regular client, came in, and her heart went into ventricular fibrillation. I was working on someone else, and she didn't have an appointment. So my helper said, you better go out, this lady doesn't look too good. I think you better come and check her. The minute I saw her, I threw her in a chair and went to work on her. She was turning green. I mean, she was dying.
Ooh.
And I thought, well, should I call the emergency medical tech? Well, it's snowing outside. I said, no, they're going to come and tramp mud and snow all over my carpet. Besides, this lady came here because she believes in reflexology. She could feel this coming on. She's here. And Bud, you better do your job. So I wasn't getting any results on this one with the machine I had because it was not the right machine because my good machine was in the room with the other client that I had left. So I threw the machine down and took my thumb and went in on this point right here. Right there. I tried. That was the third heart point that I worked. And that was the one that worked on this patient. That's why you want to know all the charts. Know all five heart points, because if one doesn't work, you can go to another one.
Ooh.
And the minute I hit that one, that woman screamed out, oh, son, you're killing me! And I just stayed on it. Within 20 seconds, her color came back. We defibbed her heart. We defibbed her heart. When I found the right point.
Wow.
You get it?
Yeah.
Isn't that exciting?
Mm-hmm.
The lady did, so I stabilized her, went back, finished the other treatment, called this lady's husband, and when I finished the treatment, took her in, gave her an hour and a half treatment. Meanwhile, her husband came, and I went out to talk to him briefly, and he came, and he looked at me, he said, son, you know your mother is a very sick woman. I said, yes, father, I understand.
But she was okay following that?
Oh, yeah.
No more heart issues?
Her husband took her home. 5 hours later, she called me. Oh, son, I came home and went to bed and I slept for 5 hours. Thank you, son, for that wonderful foot treatment. I just thank you so much.
Ooh.
And it just stabilized her. Got her through her crisis that she felt coming on before she ever came in. But if I called the emergency medical tech, she'd have probably been dead by the time they got there.
Yeah.
So you got, if you're a reflexologist, you got to step up to the plate when you're called on. You got to have the goods. You got to be able to deliver the goods in a time of crisis. And you don't get there except through proper training and experience. And that's what the Modern Institute of Reflexology is all about, to try to guide you and give you hints and help you step into something like I'm talking about. In other words, the school is a way for me to replicate myself. And I just have to put an aside in there. I don't do anything without submission to the will of the sovereign creator above. I'm a person that believes Jesus is that revelation. Okay, now I want you to close your eyes in preparation for me to stop. I want you to observe what's going on in your body. And just allow yourself to totally and completely relax. You went into a nice state of relaxation, huh?
Yeah, I could have taken a nap after that.
Oh, yeah. Well, I would let you sleep for an hour, but these guys have to move on to the next appointment. No hurry. I just wanted to get your response while they could still run the camera. So how would you describe your afterglow of the treatment when I ceased from percussing your feet?
It was great. I feel very relaxed. My feet feel very good. I still have a little bit of that tingliness in my head. So overall, I'd say it was really good.
Good. Still feel a little tingliness in your head. How can you describe that tingliness in your head?
It's like a good kind of feeling. Not exactly lightheaded, but just very relaxed and feels very light. Yeah.
Excellent. Well, we overwork our brains sometimes with mental worriment. Mm-hmm. And it's nice to get it purged of all the debris of decision over stimulation.
Definitely.
Okay, yeah. Jackie, it's been wonderful working with you. And be sure to go to our website, Modern Institute of Reflexology, and look up the self-treatment page, and we show you how to use two golf balls to get the same end result.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Well, I certainly hope you all enjoyed our demonstration today as much as I did giving it, and as much as the people did that received it. It appears everyone was overjoyed and got what they came for, and that primarily was relaxation. If you have any more questions, go to our website at www.reflexologyinstitute.com. You can order the Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager or any other of the items that we carry at the school, or even enroll in a course. We look forward to hearing from you, and thanks for watching. Welcome to the little session on maintenance of the drummer. Very important. If you take care of the drummer, it'll last a lifetime. If you don't, well, you'll bog down and you'll have to be replacing parts unnecessarily. But the nice thing about the drummer, Dr. Riley's Ultra Massager, is that you can get parts because it's made in the USA and it's a machine that'll last you the rest of your life. Okay, when it comes to servicing the cable, we have to remove the handpiece and disassemble it here at the where the shaft hooks onto the motor. Okay, we have to loosen the set screw here on the shaft where it hooks onto the shaft of a motor. There we go. Then we just simply draw the shaft out of the housing. I'm going to have a nice rag around for this because it can be due to wear particles in need of a little bit of cleaning up. So let's just take our fresh, nice, clean, white rag. In my case, it's an absorbent terry cloth towel. And now, since we're not replacing the shaft, this one's in good shape, we just want to clean it up and lubricate it. If you don't like to get your hands a little bit dirty, then hire somebody to do this for you. Okay, we're getting ready to grease up our drive shaft for the drummer with Fordham's flexible shaft lubricant. And I just believe in, oh wow, this is a new brand. That really looks good. Man, you know our company's innovative, always improving. So we want to just get this thing well lubricated, because this is going to cut down on resistance and make everything run smoother and more efficiently. How exciting. How exciting to be able to get in here and get a little greasy and do the service that's necessary to keep this thing running for a long time. Now these shafts tend to shear. It doesn't have anything to do with wear, but if you put a lot of pressure, like I do, to get the deep penetration of the percussion action on the bottom of the foot, particularly the K1 area where the musculature of the foot is nice and thick, then it's going to be important to have this well greased. Okay, we've got the shaft all greased. We're ready to run it back into the housing. So we're just going to stick it in there and run it in. Okay, we'll get our motor all set up here. There we go. Get our set screw reset so it doesn't come loose. Oh boy, I got my hands all greasy now. I can't tighten it up. Here we go. Hold on here. Here we go. Okay, so we have to get the, now these are reverse threads. Notice I'm going backwards from a normal thread like you would on a anything else. That's so that it doesn't come unscrewed from the centrifugal force. Now the question is, right here, how deeply do we push this in? Wherever you do the set screw to hold this in position is going to be determined by how far you want it sticking out. So we like it to be potentially about a half inch. So we're going to tighten it up right there. There we go. Now when you go to replace the cable housing in the shaft back into the handpiece, you want it to be going very slowly, so that it goes in and inserts itself into the hole. And there we are. We're back in business, all lubricated. Excellent. Now what we want to do is oil the handpiece. So we have here a special lubricant from Fordham, designed and selected especially for the handpiece. The bearings in the handpiece are oil impregnated, and they used to put grease in here, and I said, well, if these are oil impregnated bearings, why don't we just put oil in there? So the engineer ran a bunch of tests. He said, well, you're right. The oil is very satisfactory. Okay, in oiling the handpiece, we take our special eyedropper of Fordham machine oil, special oil for these bronze bearings, and just oil each bearing. This shaft right here needs to be oiled, so we run about 5 or 6 drops down there, and then on the handpiece, to lubricate the 5 bronze bearings in the handpiece, you want to shoot about 15 drops down underneath the flywheel. The flywheel is that large stainless steel disc looking thing. Get about 15 drops down there, fire it up, and let it work down in there. Very good. Now, I might just say that if there's a lot of wear particles, all you have to do is take some WD-40, squirt a whole bunch of it in there, turn it upside down like I am now to let all the excess WD-40 run out. Now, let's see if we get any excessive oil. After you let it lubricate, you turn it upside down and let any excessive oil run out. See, we've got a little bit there. The reason you want to do that is you don't want the oil, excessive oil, leaking out around the shaft and getting on your uniform or your clothes or your socks that you might have on the patient. Okay, we got a little excess oil out of there. And we're ready to close it up and go back to work. Okay, this is where the armature brush is hiding. We need to check that periodically, every 500, 600, 700 hours. You take this little cap screw out and pull your brush out, and there's what it looks like when it's fairly new. This has a few hours on it. You don't want to run these brushes down much farther than right about there. If you get down too far, then you're going to have metal against metal, and you can injure your brush. So if you do take these out to check it and put them back in, you want to make sure you get the wear on the armature aligned with the wear on the brush aligned with the armature. So you want to put it in so that it's exactly like it came out. There we go. Press your spring all the way in. And here's the tricky part. Get your cap screw all lined up with the threads. Good trick if you can do it the first time. And screw it in. Ah, we got it. Hallelujah. Snug it up tight, and then you got another one to do on the other side.